Okay. Hello, Paulus. In terms of Wales, I suppose the earliest references really are 18th century. There's your Puritans in the 17th, and you've got Whitfield. And of course, along with Whitfield, is Cambuslang's up in Scotland, isn't that Scottish? Is Howell Harris. Now, where is Howell Harris? So Daniel Rowland is a key figure in Wales. Daniel Rowland and the Great Evangelical Awakening in Wales. And then there's also a Banner of Truth magazine on Daniel Rowland. But it's, here we go. Here's a good one. Howell Harris and the Dawn of Revival, introduction by Lloyd Jones, who of course was Welsh. So that's 18th century, that's 1700, so 1735 onwards, Howell Harris just played a huge role in influencing Whitfield. Then we come down to the 19th century, we've got Finney. This D.L. Moody stuff is at home, because I'm, okay, and here we have, we've got Great Preachers of Wales. I must admit, I have not read that. Revival comes to Wales. So this is the 1859 revival. It is, it's completely dynamic. So I've obviously made quite a few notes. 800 people added, 6,200 people added in only 6 months. Page 97, 110,000 added altogether, spread across the denominations. So this was an amazing revival in 1859. So that's worth getting hold of, Eifon Evans. And I think you can get it online. This is about the same revival. This is a Banner of Truth book. And this, once again, it has just incredible accounts of Festiniog. Festiniog, there was such a great revival in Festiniog. Such a great revival in 1859 that those two books are the key books on it. Then I've got Salvation Army. Let me just go down here, sorry. So here we go to the Welsh Revival in 1904. So this I think is okay. Yeah, not as good. I've obviously made some notes. This little number is amazing though. The Awakening in Wales by Jessie Penn-Lewis. Tiny little book, you can see the amount of notes that I made on it. For a comment on the book, see the Welsh Revival 1904 by Eifon Evans, okay. Again, I don't think you can get this online though. And this one, again, Eifon Evans, so he's the same guy who wrote Revival Comes to Wales up there. The Welsh Revival of 1904. Again, foreword by Lloyd Jones, and again, just packed with incredible stories. In fact, maybe instead of Moody, my next big project on the Church History Review should be Wales. So those are the key books, the four key books. Revival Comes to Wales by Eifon Evans, The Welsh Revival, Thomas Phillips, that's 1859, and then Jessie Penn-Lewis, The Awakening in Wales, and The Welsh Revival of 1904. That's obviously 1904. Those are the two key books. And then another one that I've read is this one, but I've obviously not thought it was as good as those two. So that gives you some basic ideas.